Vitamin B12 deficiency happens when your body is either not getting enough or not absorbing enough vitamin B12 from food sources. And you need B12 because it's an important nutrient that helps your body make red blood cells and DNA. So you can imagine just how important that is. And it wasn't until later in the 20th century that scientists discovered B12 and just how important it is. In this video, we'll look at what vitamin B12 is, why it's important, who is more prone to a B12 deficiency, and what is the best vitamin B12 supplement on the market. So stay with me till the end. And real quick guys, before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button below for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on next to it to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Vitamin B12 is one of the 8 B vitamins. It's required by humans since we use it as a cofactor in DNA synthesis. But if I were giving it a top 2 most important roles, I would say 1, we need to make the myelin sheath for our nervous system, which provides our nerves with insulation, allowing electrical impulses to transmit quickly and efficiently along the nerve cells. And 2, because we need it to develop our red blood cells in the bone marrow. And B12 does a great job in doing both those things. Because remember, it's a coenzyme, so its presence is required for 2 big enzymes to carry out its pathway. One being methylmalonyl coenzyme A mutase in order to make the very important myelin sheath, and 2, methionine synthase, which helps us to generate THF, which is the active form of folate to make red blood cells and also the intestinal wall cells, which are important for absorption. Again, very huge important roles that B12 plays. And your body does not make vitamin B12 on its own, so you have to consume foods and drinks that have vitamin B12 in order to get it. And the best foods that will give you B12 are going to be these guys right here, so pay attention. Clams, tuna, king crab, and skirt steak. But for vegetarians, you really only have 1 or 2 options. The first is an algae called nori, as 4 grams of dried nori can meet the required vitamin B12 intake for the day.
Ooh, seaweed snacks. I don't know, it looks like paper, just some kind of wrapping paper almost.
Now I'm open for anything, so we're going to try this.
And the second is shiitake mushrooms, but the amounts are very low in these mushrooms. You're going to be better off finding foods that are fortified with B12 if you want to go the food routes. And usually the packaging on foods will tell you if it's fortified or not. And here are the daily requirements of B12 that you need. 2.4 micrograms for all adults. But there are 2 things that need to happen in order for your body to absorb vitamin B12 from the food you eat, because it's one thing getting B12, it's another thing absorbing it. First off, what needs to happen is the hydrochloric acid in your stomach has to remove vitamin B12 from the food it was in. Next, the vitamin B12 combines with something called intrinsic factor, which is a protein made by your stomach. Then the vitamin B12 is able to be absorbed by your digestive system. But here's the catch, guys. Some people have a rare condition called pernicious anemia, which means their stomach does not make enough intrinsic factor, or any at all. And because their stomach doesn't make intrinsic factor, their body can't properly absorb vitamin B12, which causes a vitamin B12 deficiency. And on that note, there's some people that don't even have enough hydrochloric acid in their stomach to absorb the vitamin B12 that's naturally present in food. If that's the case, I highly recommend you watch my video on betaine HCL and pepsin. People over 50 should ideally get most of their vitamin B12 from fortified foods or dietary supplements, because in most cases, their bodies, well, at least for some people, have a hard time absorbing B12 from food sources. And some of the signs of a B12 deficiency are disturbed vision, glossitis, where your tongue becomes inflamed and swollen, mood changes, high temperature, sensation of pins and needles in your nerves, and fatigue. So now that we talked about what B12 is, the food sources of B12, the factors that block the absorption, as well as some B12 deficiency symptoms, let's talk about what's causing this drop in B12 levels in the first place. I think that's a good place to start before we get into the supplement side. You see, your body stores 1,000 to 2,000 times as much vitamin B12 as you typically eat in a day. So the symptoms of vitamin B12 deficiency can take several years to appear. But when they do, it's important to know it's not just that your diet or how your body doesn't absorb it. It can also be from your medicines. These are 6 medicines right here that contribute to a low B12. H2 blockers, even your PPIs that you use to block acid for heartburn, these lower your hydrochloric acid levels, which you need to activate the B12. Metformin being a big player as well, which usually happens at higher doses and for longer periods of time, and a few other ones too. Then, of course, if you had surgery to remove parts of your stomach, you might have a hard time secreting HCL. Same with atrophic gastritis, which is an autoimmune condition that makes too little hydrochloric acid as well. It's important that you not only know what stops the absorption, but what other factors cause a deficiency. In fact, I want to add some more factors to the list just for completion's sake. Sjögren's syndrome can cause it too, as you're six times more likely to have a B12 deficiency with it. Following a strict vegan or vegetarian diet, which we already mentioned, or if you drink lots of alcohol, which can damage your digestive system. And testing for a B12 deficiency isn't really a thing here in the US, but you can get your levels tested if you feel like you have any of the symptoms or the conditions I mentioned. The test is called the methylmalonic test or the MMA test, and no, this has nothing to do with mixed martial arts. Basically, they will check your MMA through a blood or a urine test, and if your body doesn't have enough vitamin B12, it will make an extra amount of MMA. And high MMA levels can be a sign of a B12 deficiency. You could take the MMA with a test like a homocysteine test to get a better picture, and it's very similar. A high homocysteine level may indicate you're not getting enough B12 in your diet. And in terms of supplementing, I would go for the natural forms of B12 like methylcobalamin instead of cyanocobalamin. Both are nearly identical to each other and contain a cobalt ion surrounded by a corin ring, but you have a different molecule attached to the cobalt ion. Methylcobalamin contains a methyl group. Cyanocobalamin contains a cyanide molecule. And the one I like is the one by Thorne. They use the natural version, methylcobalamin, which you can check out in my Thorne store down below. It's exactly 1 milligram of B12, which is well thought out, like all their supplement formulations are. They participate in clinical trials and have resources all over their website for you to check out. You could also go with their B complex number 12, which has your B vitamins like B12 and your folate as well. There you could also check out my entire store and shop my top three favorite supplements. And once you begin treating your vitamin B12 deficiency, it could take up to 6 to 12 months to fully recover, which is why it's also common to not experience any improvement during the first few months of treatment. That's normal too, because with B12, it does take time to correct. But I'm more curious to hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts on vitamin B12? Leave them down below. In the meantime, hit the like button and subscribe if you found this video helpful, and I'll see you on the next one.
I don't like the smell of it either. Okay. Not that one.
If it was good for me, and it helped me lose weight and help wrinkles go away, I'd eat it.